And this one, I would like to present the criterion library, which is a library to do unit testing in C. And yeah, it was a nice surprise for me because I was looking for a unit testing library at some point in C, and I tested a bunch of them, but none of them was like just sane. Like there was a lot of boilerplate, and it wasn't simple, and like some stuff that you would expect by default were not present, and so on and so on. But anyway, Criterion is very nice, very simple, and it has like sane behavior. So yeah, let's jump into it. As you can see, I have a very simple C file with just a function that adds to number, a function that will segfault, and a function that will run forever, which is located in the lib.c file. And I have a header file for this. And then I have a test.c. And in this test.c, I have a bunch of examples. And as you can see, the criterion way of doing tests is very, very normal. So you just import criterion after you install it, of course. But I'm not going to show how to install it because you're big boys. You know how to install stuff. So yeah, here is an example of one test. So the structure is you just do tests and then parentheses and then the test suite and then the test case. So if I had multiple tests for add, I would do basic, then not so basic. And that's a bit how you structure your testing. Generally, I have a function, one test suite per function, and then all the cases I have every time a test case. And so, yeah, and in that is the code that will be executed for testing. And as you can see, I just execute the function, and then I use an assert statement from criterion. They all start with CR underscore, and then assert, and then there is a bunch of assert statements that I will show. But let's run this. So I just compile all the C files and I link it with Criterion, and Criterion will automatically create a main for you and do everything. So that's basically the only code you need to like create a test executable, which is really nice. And as you can see here, it's a very basic test, and we have one test and one passing, but let's say make it fail on purpose. And yeah, one test, one failing, and it tells you that the result is supposed to be 3. And yeah, that's basically what you would expect. And there is two ways of doing assertions in Criterion. One is just assert, which will just kill the test. Like if you try to log something after that, it won't do anything. Like it will just stop the test, as you expect. But there is also an expect, which is just like assert, but like will like mark the test as fail, but still keep try to run the next instructions, which can be handy sometime. So as you can see here, we have the line, the log line was executed, but even though the test failed. And there is a bunch of asserts. So there is like equal, which is what you expect, but you can also have just a custom one where you can have just any condition you want in there. So like so, let's see, we take back two, or like not equal, and so on and so on and so on. You have you can assert on pointers. So if you do int p is equal to null. And then you can assert that a pointer is null, something like this. Can I like make it this again? Like this, you see it passed. You can assert not null. I mean, you see with the autocomplete that it's pretty like this. I can actually do. So there is like what you would expect, like greater than, greater equal, not, null, fail. There is a bunch for the strings, which are very handy. So you can do a string equal and or string empty or not empty. Let's just do an equal just for the sake of it. Hello, hello. Comment this one out. Pass, and then you modify the string. And doesn't pass. That's pretty much what you expect. And you have a bunch of assert functions like this. So feel free to look up the documentation, which I will put in the description for those. Next, it automatically by default catches a sec fault. So yeah, and the previous unit testing library that I used, like just a sec fault would be just a sec fault, which is annoying. Here you actually have a nicer output where it says actually this test has crashed, and it will run the other tests if it even though there is a sec fault, because it like every single test case is in a separate process, if I'm not mistaken. That's kind of nice, and you can actually catch like make a test that would expect a sec fault by adding an extra argument at the end of the test macro with signal is equal to sig secv, and here it would mark the test as passing. And if I'm not mistaken, if it doesn't sec fault, it would mark it as fail. Yeah, so you can make a test that expects a failure, and I think you can do a bunch, not only sec fault, but like sig int or sig abort or sig kill or stuff like that. So yeah, that's pretty nice. Next is a timeout. So if you have some tests that can hang forever, but you don't want that, you can add the timeout parameter, which is in seconds, I think. And so here, this function is just a forever loop. And if I run this, it will say that this timed out. And yeah, I think by default there is no timeout, so if you just leave it running like this, it will just keep running forever. So you have to specify a timeout, or you can specify also a global timeout, which I will show later. Right. So as you can see, there is a lot of like default behavior that makes just sense, like catching timeouts and sec faults and so on and so on. Next is having like a setup and tear down function kind of thing, like just like you're used to in most unit testing libraries. So here it's very simple. You just have a setup function, a tear down function. You can put whatever you want in them, and you add the extra argument init and fini in the test case to be equal to those functions. And it does what you would expect. Huh? So this is executed before, and then it prints whatever the test is doing. And then this is like the cleanup, so the teardown here. Next is you can actually like test on std out, or I think std in as well. But I've never tried the std in. But yeah, so don't forget to like import criterion slash redirect. But then you can do cool stuff like just call redirect std out, and then you just like, I don't know, print whatever you want to print. Don't forget to flush, because otherwise it won't work. And then you can do cr assert std out equal string. And it will just, basically it captures the std out somewhere, and you can then assert that it's equal to something. And as you can see, this works, but if I change this, it does not. And as you can see, if I don't flush, it does not work. And so yeah, that's quite handy, especially if you have like, well, you're making a function that print something to std out, and there is no way of modifying like which file it's writing to or something like that. So yeah, that's quite handy. Next, yes, I wanted to show quickly the test. So let me run this. Maybe not this one. Let me just uncomment a bunch of them and make this one true. Sure, whatever, good enough. Anyway, so the executable it will generate actually has a bunch of flags. You can look them up in more detail, but I will just look at those three, which are cool. So there is one that will just list all the tests that are going to be executed, which can be a nice summary. There is also one, if you have like a lot of tests, you can specify the J to run them in parallel. So here we won't see a difference in speed, of course, because I have very small tests, but that can be useful. And then there is the F, fail fast, which will stop the testing executable as soon as there is like only one test that fails, which can be handy if you don't want like too much verbose output and you just want to work on one failure at a time. So yeah, as you can see here, it executed only one test instead of four, so it just stopped at this first one. So if I create an error here, and here I have two fail, but if I put fail fast, I only have one. And so yeah, that's pretty much it for criterion. You can do more advanced stuff. I know you can have like parameterized tests where you have the same code running but with different parameters, so it's a bit more concise. They call it like theories or something, like yeah. So parameterized test, and there is another thing called theories, which I'm not familiar with. But mainly, yeah, those are, you can do, you can have a log message. Oh, I showed this in the beginning, actually. Yeah, you can hook into the different parts of the library, like before you run a test or stuff like this. But yeah, that's mainly it. So it's quite a simple library, very clean and very clear to understand. So yeah, I recommend it, and that's the one I use in every single one of my C projects from now on. So yeah, hopefully that was useful information to you. Ah yes, and also I'm not gonna show this now, but you can generate coverage information with it, which is quite nice. Anyway, hope this video helps. Yeah, unit testing helps a lot, but it was a bit tricky at first for me in C, but now it's not, thanks to this nice library. So yeah, anyway, that's it. See you.